So I've got the original Windows XP install disk. Look at the packaging that this comes in. It looks pretty nice. You can see all of the features they were advertising. Roam if you want to. Windows XP automatically recognizes the 802.11 network you're near to and connects to it. Free yourself from your office. Remote desktop gives you control of your own computer while on the go. Yeah, that sounds like a security issue. So I went around to find a computer that I can install Windows XP on, and it's hard to find a computer that can read disks. DVD ROMs are really hard to find. After a while, I decided to use this old Dell server workstation thing, specifically the Dell Precision T3610. It fits the only criteria I have. It has a DVD ROM. It was kind of dusty, especially around the power supply area, but I blew it out with a reverse vacuum, and it's not that bad. Looking inside, there's a small cooler for the Xeon processor, this little speaker, and a graphics card. The rest is pretty standard server stuff. I powered it on and went into the BIOS, which is pretty basic. One of the settings that caught my eye was the fan speed control, which, well, controls the fans. If you want to know what the fans sound like on high, okay, so I'm gonna set the fans back to normal. So I booted it up and everything works just fine. I put in the install disk and was ready to install. It's interesting that the disk still has an installer, which runs on Windows 10. I guess its main purpose is to check for compatibility. Just so you know, I'll be running this inside of a virtual machine for security. It's like a computer inside of a computer, and it gives me more control over things like connecting to the internet. I had to go to the settings for the virtual machine to pass the disk through. This makes the virtual machine think that a disk is directly connected to it. I started up and you can already hear the drive spinning. It gave a very basic text-based installer, and you can see it loading all the files at the bottom. That goes on for quite a while, but it finally says, "Welcome to Startup," and you can see options to install, repair, or quit the installer. It displays the license agreement, which I very carefully read, and after that, it allows me to choose the drive that I want to install Windows XP to, then starts installing. First, it got the drive partitioned correctly for the install, and then it started copying the files, which is where the drive really sped up. It took a while, but it finally says that this portion of setup is completed, and that if there's a floppy disk, I need to remove it. It restarts the computer into a nicer looking graphical install, but right before that was the first look at the iconic startup screen. It took some time to get ready, but shows some nice stuff to read. Windows XP Professional sports a brand new visual design that combines a sleek look, clean lines, and appealing colors, with a task-oriented design and exceptionally streamlined navigation. Windows Update provides you with critical software updates and hardware support. Yeah, everyone loves Windows Update. It eventually popped up where you can change your region, input your name, and this is where my heart sunk. The product key input. I had to activate Windows. No problem. I'll just go to the back of the installation box and type in that product key. It didn't work. I tried many other product keys that I had on hand, and those didn't work either. I checked another virtual machine that I had activated and used the same exact product key. Nothing was working. So, I sadly quit the VM and never turned it back on. But that's not exciting. I mentioned that other virtual machine that I had activated before, and that was working. Well, I ended up using that for the rest of the video. So here it is. It's kind of stuck at this squarish resolution, and it doesn't look the best. So after installing the drivers, it fits the whole screen as the classic Windows XP wallpaper. The first thing I'm going to do is check the Windows XP tour. It gives me two options for the tour, the animated and non-animated version, which is the one I'm choosing. I don't want to play copyrighted music or anything. Now, it has a ton of options for the tour. I'm going to choose Windows XP Basics, and it opens up the separate page. It has some nice graphics, and this text box labeled the Windows Desktop. Using XP is simple. First, you'll notice the large area on the screen called the desktop, and the narrow band at the bottom called the taskbar. Yeah, this is a really simple explanation, but then I looked at the top and saw that it was a link to an HTM file. Of course, I had to see what this file was. I opened a file explorer and went to the C drive. When I clicked on it, it told me these files are hidden because the files inside keep my computer running properly and I should not modify anything. Then it lets me proceed anyway. I went to Help, Tours, then HTML tour. and here were the contents of the tour. It's kinda cool to see everything. If I copy everything to my modern day Windows 10 computer, it still works. It's weird to see the side by side. Well, that was pretty interesting to see Windows XP being installed off of a disk in 2021. Besides the activation not always functioning, everything else works just fine. That's pretty much it for this video. Thank you for watching. We'll be right back.